John Prescott, lacking none of his usual vigour, delivered a scathing attack on the government's record on transport and promised a radical programme of public investment and borrowing to tackle overcrowding and congestion, especially in the southeast. Labour's plans for the region include switching funds from road building to public transport and overhauling London's bus network. Next week, the party will announce details of easy borrowing terms for bus companies who want to put more vehicles on the most congested routes in London. The party also plans a London orbital rail link, joining up existing routes. John Prescott dismissed criticisms that Labour don't know how much the schemes will cost or where the money will come from.
You need a lot of mega bucks, basically, to build the new systems. We are now looking at how they might privately borrow a lot of that and lease a lot of the stock and use their development potential, which are prevented by the silly Treasury rules, which Neil Kinnock announced yesterday are about to change.
Meanwhile, former Battersea MP Alf Dubbs is claiming he has evidence the government is considering reviving plans to turn London's South Circular Road into a motorway.
And the trouble with that is it's going to have a damaging knock-on all through South London. It's going to mean more congestion, it's going to mean blight, it's going to mean environmental damage, and I know the people of South London don't want it.
Improved transport is central to Labour's hopes of revitalising the capital. Shadow Environment Secretary Brian Gould today launched a three-month consultation period on the party's plans for London. Key is the return of a strategic London authority, strongly supported by the chairman of the Association of London Authorities during the debate on regional government.
It means that while the government has given us the highest fares in Europe, five times as high as Paris and Athens, Labour will bring them down again. It means that while the government have thrown the homeless on the streets, Labour will give them a home to call their own.
Labour have today begun to put the flesh on the bones of their policies for the capital, policies they hope will tip the balance in the key London marginals they must win in order to gain power at the election. This is Jane Ball at the Labour Party conference in Brighton for Thames News.